Previously, we looked at the conform workflow and the first scenario where Smoke would link to the media files in their original locations to rebuild the sequence in Smoke. Let's now look at the second scenario. You have been working in your NLE and you simply export an AAF or XML. During your preparation, you might choose to consolidate and transcode your media. Finally, you copy the media onto a hard drive and move it across your network to be accessed by another machine. So whether you are using one drive, multiple drives, or your network to transport your media, there is the very strong possibility that the absolute file locations written into the XML or AAF file don't point to the new media location, making them pretty much useless. This is where relative searching in Smoke will come in to help locate the media and successfully rebuild the sequence. So to illustrate this scenario, I'll start off in the Mac OS Finder. After exporting my AAF or XML, I copied my media between two locations. The first location on this hard drive contains a production folder where I have my AAF or XML file and a subfolder containing half of my media for the conform. The second location on a different hard drive contains another production folder and a subfolder containing the rest of my media for the conform. For this explanation, I am just using two locations, but you could have multiple locations where you might have copied or moved your media to. Now let's switch into Smoke. Select a folder in the media library as the location for the incoming sequence clip. Choose the gear menu and select to load a new XML or AAF. In the file browser, navigate to the location of the XML or AAF on the first hard drive. Double-click on the XML or AAF to bring up the preview player to verify its metadata in the clip information. In the sequence import options, you can tell Smoke how to search for the media. If the media has not been moved or was still in the same location, then the AAF or XML would be all you need to locate your media. Since the media was moved or copied to another location, you need to enable Search and Import Files to search near the location of the XML or AAF. With the relative search options enabled, you can now define the criteria for the search. In the case of XMLs, you need to search for the file name with the matching frame rate. With Avid AAFs, you could also perform a search based on UMIDs, which is specific to the Avid workflow. If you were conforming using DPX, then the only criteria that really matter are tape name and timecode embedded in the DPX file sequence. This is just to name a few other situations. In this case, file name and frame rate are sufficient. Clicking Import initiates the search for the media files near the XML and AAF as well as the subfolders. It finds a few matches and rebuilds the sequence. We can now see the sequence open in the timeline view and event list with all the corresponding entries. You can see straight away in the status column which entries are linked and which entries are not. The sequence also displays red icons on the segments that are unlinked and require media. So you have quite a visual warning in the sequence and event list that there are issues requiring your attention. Selecting the linked entries verifies their existence in the sequence and the footage is correct. So for clarity in the events list, select the options pull-down menu and choose Hide Linked. Now you only see the entries that need to locate their media. To seek out and find the missing media, you need to define locations to look for the missing media. At the bottom of the events list, click the Set Search Directory button. This launches the file browser and you can start to look for the missing media. The extra footage is located on my second drive. By selecting a folder, all the contents, including the contents in the subfolders, will be considered in the search for the missing media. Let's perform the search and see what we get. Back in the Conform tab, the event list has already scanned the media found in the searched location and identified one match for each of the remaining source entries. You can see this by the match symbol in the status column. Now that Smoke has found the matches for the unlinked segments in the sequence, you can either link one selected entry at a time, or you can link all the match sources to the sequence with one click. The event list is now empty because all the media has been linked into the sequence. You can now switch to the Timeline tab and start working in Smoke. In the next video, we'll take on another scenario where we deal with different resolutions, formats, and media in external locations as well as in the media library. All that to come next.